In this question, we have a massless spring, the spring constant, 74 newtons per meter, and it's hanging from the ceiling. Let's draw a diagram to give us an image of what's going on. So we have an unstretched spring, and then we're going to hang a 490 gram mass onto the unstretched spring and release the mass, allowing it to drop. So that means that my initial conditions is that I hang my mass on my spring and it's not in equilibrium. I let go, so its initial velocity is zero, and then it's going to accelerate downwards. And at some point, the force from the spring will be enough to stop the mass. Its final velocity will be zero, and it'll start to undergo simple harmonic motion, backwards and forwards, about some new equilibrium position, which is going to be halfway between those two points. We're asked to find the amplitude and the period of the resulting motion. If I interpret this, I think the way I'm going to approach this problem is to look at energy. We know the initial conditions here, when the velocity is equal to zero, the kinetic energy at that point is also equal to zero. And when my mass reaches the point where it turns around as it's undergoing motion between these two points here and here, oscillating backwards and forwards, this place also, we know that the kinetic energy is equal to zero. So if we treat this as our initial point, this is our final point, we know that the kinetic energy is zero at both of those points. Now there are another couple of energies that we can consider here. We also know that the reason why the mass accelerates downwards is there's gravity, and therefore we can think about the potential energy that that mass has. Remembering that potential energy is something that we can arbitrarily set one level of, and it's really the change in potential energy which matters. So I will set my initial potential energy here to be equal to mg times my change in height, and my final potential energy down here, I can set that to be equal to zero. Because what I really care about is the change in potential energy, and I've written this in such a way that we realize that potential energy due to gravitational field always increases as we move up. Sticking with potential energy for a moment, let's see if I can define that change in height a little bit less arbitrarily. If I think about the motion that's going to undergo, this is simple harmonic motion, and I'm going to be oscillating about this equilibrium position at some amplitude. So in fact, if I take upwards as being positive, then I will oscillate between some negative A and some positive A. That means that my total change in height is actually equal to 2A. So I can say that that potential energy is actually equal to 2 times M times G times the amplitude of oscillation. Now there's also a third source of potential energy I need to concern myself with, and that is that not only is energy stored in the gravitational field, but energy is stored in the spring. So this is the potential energy due to gravity. We also have the potential energy due to my spring. Now, if I think about potential energy which is stored in a spring, that basically goes as a half times k times my extension of my spring squared. This is my spring extension. It's how far I've stretched my spring. So if I was to plot out, remembering that if I was to pull on my spring, I'd be exerting some force. That force would be equal to k times x, the spring constant times the displacement. So if I pull on my spring with some force over some displacement x, then the area underneath the curve here is going to give me the work which is done. And that work that I do on the spring is also stored as potential energy in the spring. So that area there is my half kx squared. So what I want to think about is how much energy is stored in my spring. Now initially, the spring is in an unstretched state. Even when I hook the mass on and just place it on there, and just before I release it, as soon as I release it, the spring starts to extend. So when the velocity is equal to zero, the spring at the top of this motion of this simple harmonic motion is still in an unstretched state. So both of these figures here, hopefully you realize the spring is unstretched, which means the energy which is stored in the spring is going to be zero. At the bottom of the motion here, the final position, then what is the amount of stretching that my spring has undergone? It's a half times k times how much is my extension? Well, my extension, as you can see, the string has stretched by amount of 2a. So it's 2a all squared. So if I look at energy conservation here, I can see that my change in any energy from the initial point to the final point, my kinetic energy is zero. I start with all of my energy being stored in the gravitational field. So 2mg times a is all of the energy I have initially. And then my final condition, all of that potential energy has been transferred into stored in potential energy in the spring. So I can write that these two amounts of energy must be the same. So this is energy conservation, is really what I'm using here. No way of removing energy from the system, so that my spring is not damped at all. So part A asked me to find the amplitude of the oscillation. In this expression here, I actually know what the mass is, I know what K is, I know what G is, so I can use this to find the amplitude. So 2mgA is equal to, now 2a squared gives me 4a squared, and so 4 times a half is 2ka squared. I have an a cancelling on the left hand side with one on the right hand side. Solving for my amplitude now, the 2's cancel as well. I just end up with mg divided by k. So I put some numbers in there, 0.49 times 9.8 divided by 74. I will get 0.0649, which is really 6.5 centimeters as my amplitude. So that's the answer for part A. For part B, we're asked to find the period of the resulting motions. In fact, that's a much easier thing to do. We could have gotten that straight away, because we know that the period is equal to 1 over the frequency, and we know that the frequency is related to omega over 2 pi. Take these things and put them together to write that the period is going to be given by 2 pi over omega, which looks like 2 pi times the square root of m over k. So k over m is omega, so 1 over omega is m over k in the square root sign. So 2 pi times the square root of 0.49 divided by 74. And that period is actually equal to half a second, 0.5 seconds. Let's just do a little bit of assessment there, just to think about what was going on. Once again, we use conservation of energy to think about the situation initially, where I've got my kinetic energy, my potential energy due to gravity, and my potential energy of a spring. The initial condition was the unstretched spring, and therefore I had no kinetic energy. All of my energy was stored as potential energy, and there was no energy in my spring. Then my spring is going to be stretched, so at some point its velocity is going to be equal to the maximum velocity. This is when the mass is at the going through the position, its new equilibrium position. It oscillates about that point. So at that point, we actually have a distribution here. We have a little bit of energy stored as kinetic energy. We still have some energy stored in the gravitational field, because we're not at the bottom of our oscillatory motion. And we have a little bit of energy stored in the spring, because the spring has stretched. And then finally, mass reaches the bottom here. We can say that its kinetic energy is zero again. Once again, its velocity is zero at the bottom. The potential energy is now zero, and all of that energy has been transferred into the spring, stored potential energy inside the spring.